welcome back. In today's episode, we're talking cinematic photography, and I'll be getting into detail and talking about three ways in which you can make your photos look more cinematic. So before diving straight into the list, let's talk a bit about cinematic photography and what is cinematic photography. Now, cinematic street photography, it differs a bit from street photography because street photography generally is a bit more documentary style, and you're simply just recording what's on the street. Whereas with cinematic street, it's all about creating the story or telling the story through subjects on the street. So there's a small difference in the definition there, but to be honest, as there is no set and clear way to define cinematic photography or even street photography for that matter, it pretty much is up to you, and you as the artist, you as the photographer, get to define what your work is. Now, to be honest, when people talk about cinematic photography, normally they're speaking about the kind of nostalgic look of cinema. So those films which were filmed on 35mm film and have that real classic look. Because as you guys know, films can look very different from each other. You take a film like Amelie, where there's lots of green tones, it looks completely different from a film like Inception or any other modern Hollywood film. So even in cinema, there's no one defined look which people can say is a cinematic look. And the same goes for cinematic street photography. But yeah, that's enough of the semantics. Let's get straight into this list. And firstly and foremost, it's all about color. So as photographers, we can use color to help tell a story, add depth to our images, or create a certain mood. So when we talk about film, there's usually color specialists on board which will look at everything, because they want to make sure that the colors on set, the colors the characters are wearing, all fit the narrative or the story. Now, when it comes to cinematic photography, my recommendation is you do a really deep dive on color theory. Now, you probably want to get yourself a color wheel, memorize it off by heart, so when you're out on the street taking photos, you know which colors work together. So an example would be this shot here. When I was walking down the street, I spotted this purple rain cover, and I knew if a subject with a yellow coat or a yellow umbrella walked past, the colors would pop and it would make for a really interesting shot. So there's a couple of ways color can impact the scene and tell a story. For example, green can represent greed, or red can represent anger, blue sadness, whereas warmer colors like orange can represent comfort. In general, what you have to remember is lots of work goes into color and film and getting those colors right. So if you can get the colors right in your photography as well, it's gonna make your shots appear more cinematic as well. So the main point here is learn color theory in detail, get yourself a color wheel, and really master which colors work with each other. Because if you have that kind of knowledge just imprinted in your mind, when you're out taking shots, it's going to be a lot easier to capture more impactful photos, and your shots in general are just going to look a lot better if you understand colors. So next up, it's about picking your subject in your frame very carefully. Now, the way I like to think about it is the subject in your shot is like the lead actor in your film. So you really have to wait until the right subject comes in the frame, and you don't want to rush your shots or take a shot with a subject which doesn't really fit the frame or fit the story you're trying to tell. Because just like color, your subject can also help tell a story, convey an emotion, and create a mood. For example, if one of your subjects in frame looks sad, that's gonna convey a certain story and narrative to the audience and the viewer. And the same goes for if your subject is happy. Or if you want a more mysterious look, perhaps you want your subject to be a silhouette. But in all, you just wanna be really picky when it comes to subjects. So the way I like to do it is I find scenes, and I'll make a mental note of the area and the composition. I'll try some test shots, and then I'll either wait until the correct subject comes into frame. If it's a city I live in, I make it a location I just keep coming back to. Or if I'm traveling, I'll just wait there for 20 minutes, 30 minutes, sometimes an hour, just until the right subject walks into the frame. So my third and final point is light. Now, light will play a major role in whether your photo looks cinematic or not. You really have to think about how much thought and effort goes into lighting films. So one film which comes to mind is The Joker, and the cinematographer Lawrence Sher, he done an interview with Vanity Fair recently where he spoke about filming one of the scenes during blue hour because he wanted to convey a certain feel and a certain mood in that scene. Now, if you think about that, that's a Hollywood film, one of the biggest ones that year. They have a huge budget, and if they wanted to, they could light that scene artificially. But the cinematographer wanted natural light, and that's because there is no real way to replicate natural light. So think about that in your photography. So be mindful of which time of the day you shoot in, because that will have a direct impact on how your images look, the story it conveys, the mood it conveys. If you shoot during blue hour, you can get more of a moody kind of look and feel. If you shoot during the evening while it's raining, again, you're gonna get a more moody and a more darker tone to your images. Whereas if you're going for a more happy and warm feel, you may want to shoot in the early morning during golden hour, where you get that warm glowing light, or in the golden hour in the evening, again, where you can get that nice warm orange light on your subjects. As I said earlier, you may want to apply this to your photos if you're trying to get that cinematic look, because what makes a cinematic scene appear to be cinematic is mostly down to the light. Also, when it comes to lighting, also have a think about the weather conditions as well. Now, I like to call them nature's special effects. So that's the rain, the fog, or the haze, anything like that, because they can also help give your shots a more cinematic look. There's a reason why so many scenes in films are filmed under these conditions. They look more interesting, and by adding these to our photos, we can also help make them look more cinematic as well. So I'm just gonna go through a couple of my shots on Instagram and talk about how I made those shots and why I feel they look cinematic. So this one here is all about the subject. So I was walking past the cinema, I saw this dude here with the triangle hat on. I'm not exactly sure what it is. And he was just sitting there writing something. So when I saw him, I knew it was just a great subject. It's the kind of subject which gets people talking, and people kind of attach stories to the subject in the frame. So whenever you find a great subject like that, just try to capture them in interesting ways. So next up, this one is a bit different in that it was actually taken in a park. And it was on a foggy morning. This was taken at about 6 a.m. It was freezing cold. And I found this scene. I saw the two trees, and it was just a matter of waiting until the subject walked by. So due to the conditions, he came out as a silhouette, but I just feel like it works perfectly for this scene. And it's actually one of my favorite shots, which I took last year. So this shot here, I took in Osaka, and the rain and the light from the car helps give it that real cinematic look. It is actually one of my favorite shots I took on that trip. And yeah, there's just something about rain in the city with the car lights and the way the lights reflect off the floor when it's wet that help just give the images a more cinematic look to them. So yeah, that's three ways you can help make your photos look more cinematic. I've got an episode where I edit my cinematic shots and go through the process of how I make my images look more cinematic in Lightroom. I'll drop the link to that down below. And I also have a preset pack of cinematic presets if you guys are interested in that. But if you guys have any questions regarding cinematic photography, drop them down below. Or if you have any of your tips of your own, again, drop them in the comments and I'll make sure to get back to you. A massive thanks for watching this episode. Stay safe, and I'll catch you in the next one.